My youngest heartless, so they ain't playing no games. We really want him dead. He got hit up close range. He fucked up in the head. He wanna see some more brains.
Hey guys, how's it going, and welcome to the first look at the new country Russia in War Selection. If you don't know what War Selection is, then take a look in the description and you can find out exactly what this game is all about. Anyways, Russia looks amazing. I wouldn't say overpowered, but I haven't played with them yet in a game. With there being a few more units to choose from, I feel like it's going to add a bit of variety to the industrial stage, and these units will most likely be used for different situations in the late game. Russia looks very tanky, and with some new anti-aircraft unit they may start being a go-to for a lot of people, and they do not look that expensive either. Sadly, it doesn't look like there's any boats or air units with Russia, but let's find out exactly what it is you can do with this brilliant looking country. Although there are no new buildings with this country, it makes up for that with the amount of new units that you get. Let's start with the soldier unit. Similar to any other soldier in most countries, or I thought so, but there is a bit of a twist. There's a cap on each building, the same as with Asia's barracks and archeries and stables, so you can only build three at a time with each barracks. So this will force people in Russia to build a few more of these and put a few more resources into that. Overall, pretty average range and damage to any other soldier. Oh, and they can throw grenades at heavy armoured units and buildings too, so you better watch out for them. The next unit we'll be looking into is the Partisan. What makes this unit so special in my opinion is that they cost absolutely nothing to make. They also have a deadly slug shot that spreads on distance that does less damage. I mean, if you are getting destroyed, and as a last resort you can refill your population on just Partisan for free. Even with a shorter range, if you can get a few of these spread around your base, it will make a great defensive unit. Did I mention these units come from houses? No? Well, you can only make one every 150 seconds, but a free 20 to 25 units from your houses, it's just brilliant. The next unit I will introduce is the new horse unit, the Red Devil. A brilliant name for a deadly unit. Although it is pretty similar to any other cavalry in Industrial 1, I should say, they are a little bit cheaper, and the downside is they are a little bit slower. I think this will still be a viable unit into taking out cannons and knocking economy in the late game, but yeah, not too bad. Moving on to our cannon from Industrial 1, the Death Scythe. Very similar to the Turkey cannon, except they shoot a spread of bullets to affect all the units in that radius. This is going to be extremely effective against all types of units, although their damage against tanks are not that great. I think you need some Red Devils or soldiers just to back these guys up. If you have a stack of them, they can take out a lot of units very quickly. Now we have a completely new unit that has been added to the game, and it was most definitely needed with the recent aviation patch, the anti-aircraft Takanka. This little horse pulling machine gun is going to be brilliant for your base defense against people rushing with stacks of balloons or aeroplanes. They are a little bit expensive, but the best part about them is they shoot whilst they are moving. Which means, of course, you can take out any bomb balloons pretty easily and not take a single bit of damage, and their armor's pretty decent too. Okay, so now we have seen all our land type units, let's see what stuff we have on wheels from the factory. There are three new tanks, the T-34, the IS-2, and the flamethrower tank. Right now, I think the flamethrower tank is bugged, as it sort of shoots to the side of the enemies and doesn't actually hit them all the time. Hopefully this will get fixed soon. I still think it will be an effective unit. With such high armor and damage, you can hopefully make a way into your enemy's base and take out their economy. With Russia, all three of their tanks have extremely high armor, so this country is going to be great if you're an aggressive type player and like to take people out, as you can just roll straight past their defenses, hopefully, and take them out. Like any other tanks, the T-34 and IS-2 shoot whilst moving, and the ranges on both of them are pretty good. The T-34 is also an upgrade from the light tank in IR-1, so you can't make this until IR-2, but I believe they are a little bit faster. With the IS-2 tank costing 12 population, I don't think I'll be using much of this. It's too expensive, and this is only going up against one howitzer, and you can see how much damage it's taking. You would need quite a large stack of these in order to try and get through any defences, so try and avoid these in my opinion. I may be wrong, but we'll see. And the very last unit that we will talk about in this video, probably the one you have been waiting for, as this is the one that's going to cause mayhem. The rocket launcher. It could have been a different name, but upgraded from the howitzer in IR1, this unit is going to be an extremely deadly one. One of these on their own looks bad enough, but can you imagine a stack of 5 or 10, or even more? This is going to be a great unit to attack people with who have just gone for the wonder and sort of sat out the side of the game, building their defences, and you can attempt to do some damage from a distance. And of course, this is also going to be a great unit to stick behind some walls or on the edge of some land against some surprise sea attacks maybe. This will be a go-to unit for a lot of people just because of how fun it will be to use. Well, there you go guys, no added buildings or sea units with Russia or any aviation, but there is definitely a lot of variety that comes with this country. If I were you, I'd get the country just to join in on the fun from the rocket launchers. I'm really looking forward to some team games just to find out how deadly Russia is going to be. If you like this video, then press that thumbs up down below. Comment if I missed anything at all, or let me know how I can do it any better. Press that big old subscribe button if you have stuck around for this long. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, peace. Fucked up in the head.